John. Big John.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6 foot six and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't say much, he kind of quiet and shy. And if you spoke at all, you just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land, Big John.
All right, I almost screwed it up. Cindy told me that I left Friday night, so I took her word for it. Thanks, Cindy.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps a-rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. I bet there's rich folks eating from a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free.
Well, it's been a very good trip so far. The food is excellent. Great breakfast, great burger for lunch, and a very good steak for dinner. The bad part of the trip is I've lost every game I played against Steven. Of course, you can't win them all like I usually do, as everybody all knows. I'm a game player. Well, last night we got to bed in the hotel and got some good rest. Of course, I left my alarm on, and we woke up. It woke us up at 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm sure Steve would appreciate that. And we got a shuttle to the Amtrak terminal. Quite an impressive place. And we just boarded and had our breakfast, and we're headed over the Rocky Mountains right now.
They say don't go on Wolverton Mountain if you're looking for a wife, 'cause Clifton Clowers has a pretty young daughter. He's mighty handy with a gun and a knife. Her tender lips,
her tender lips,
are sweeter than honey, and Wolverton Mountain protects her there. The bears and the birds tell Clifton Clowers if a stranger should enter there, all of my dreams are on Wolverton Mountain. I want his daughter for my wife. I'll take my chances and climb that mountain, though Clifton Clowers, he might take my life. Her tender lips,
her tender
or sweeter than honey, and Wolverton Mountain protects her there. The bears and the birds tail Clifton Cloud.
Doug's picking up the dominoes after I destroyed him again.
Kill me.
How would you describe it, Doug?
A bloodbath.
I think that's pretty accurate.
If a stranger should wander there, I'm going up on Wolverton Mountain. It's too lonesome down here below. It's just not right to hide his daughter from the one who loves her so.
Go.
Well, I had my first night sleeping on a train. It was, the bed's really comfortable. Slept pretty good, slept pretty much all night long, except for a couple times I had to get up. Now it's Sunday morning and we're headed across the High Plains and fixing to go into the Reno area.
We're close to San Francisco, suburb of San Francisco. Just got off our long train ride across the Rockies and the Sierra Madres, and it was quite a deal. Saw a lot of country I haven't seen before. A couple of places I have been at the very end. I've been up around the Tahoe area and stuff. Of course, I've been to San Francisco. It was really amazing, everything we saw. And now I'm gonna wash my stinky body and I'm gonna probably get in bed pretty soon and dream about winning a game of Scrabble maybe on the way back.
Well, the last update I gave was in San Francisco, and we got on the train, and we went down to Bakersfield, and we got on a bus, and we went here to LA, and now we're on a train. And so far today, I've only lost one game. I only played one game, but I only lost one game. Steven is undefeated, except for the game where he pretended that his pad ran out of juice and he couldn't finish. He might have won that one too, though.
Just a comment, today's game was another bloodbath.
Oh, it was a terrible bloodbath.
The rest of the trip was pretty uneventful, but I wanted to summarize by just thanking Doug for all his many years of helping this company be as awesome as it is. Couldn't have been done without you, Doug. And this trip was a small token of my gratitude. Thank you.